Greetings and welcome to another thrilling and exciting episode of the Planetary Persuader. I am Cosmic Kev, your host, and this is the week beginning with Friday, the 4th of November, 2016. So, what do we have in the stars today? Well, this week, what we're enjoying is, this is the last full week of Mars being in Capricorn. And probably the last full week of Venus being in Sagittarius. So enjoy those two while you can, where they're at. We've got a moon in Capricorn this weekend, as far as I can tell. And let's see, where is that going? Where is that taking us? Sun's in Scorpio. Moon's in Capricorn. And the moon will be in Aquarius on Sunday. So you got Friday and Saturday with the Capricorn moon. Sunday with the moon in Aquarius. And then of course we've got the nice Pisces moon on Tuesday and through most of Thursday, Tuesday afternoon through Thursday, and when we get to Wednesday night, we have that nice moon trine sun. So that's going to be a really good Pisces moon with sun in Scorpio, so I'd be amped out about that. But without going too crazy, let's just do it sign by sign. Your sign, beginning with Aries, so here we go. Greetings, Aries, and welcome to your horoscope. So, now when the sun's in Scorpio, it's transiting your eighth house. Now, the eighth house is the house of birth, death, other people's property, occult studies, sex, and things you don't necessarily have power over. They say unjust rewards, inheritance. Did I say sex? Yes, I did. Earlier, so I got somebody's attention. So those things are more happening now with Venus in your ninth house in Sagittarius, and along with Saturn. This has been a time where we're establishing practical ways of using our resources and our needs, and even expressing art in more practical ways. So this is actually, overall, what I'd say, a very good sign, a good thing to do. Now, Mercury will go into Sagittarius next week, so we're not too concerned with that. Overall, I would just say, there's this fine balance right now between Uranus and Jupiter in your relationship house. So Jupiter's in Libra in your relationship house, bringing a lot of joy in your relationships, but you also have a lot of trickster independent spirit about you, and that might be where the conflict lies. Plus, you might have taken on a lot more responsibility when with Mars transiting your midheaven. And you got Pluto in there with it, so. All right, greetings, Taurus. Welcome to your horoscope. So, for you Taurus people, Scorpio time is a really good time because it rules your seventh house. And so, you know, relationship issues are overall good. I mean, Mercury and Sun together in the seventh house. You're having peaceful communication, good negotiation, and you're going through some amount of transformation as far as how you deal with your relationship and whatnot, but and it can get a little ego-crushing with Saturn transiting your eighth house. The weekend looks fun, though. This is like a really good weekend for Taurus people to get away if you were taking a little, especially Friday and Saturday with Moon and Taurus in Capricorn. That's a good travel weekend for you in the ninth house. Good time to go to the ashram. A good time to do like a really good hike or physical event too, because of I think that's like New York Marathon might be happening then. But with Mars and Pluto still in Capricorn as well, that brings a certain amount of strength and reaching for the top. Otherwise, I mean, continue to work on your health, continue to move forward. Don't take, you know, unjust rewards personally, as Saturn and Venus transit your eighth house. It happens. Well, hello, Gemini, and welcome to your horoscope. So, now, Gemini, your key phrase is I communicate. Now, Scorpio rules your sixth house. Sixth house is the gymnasium. It's about physical activity. It's about working with other people. And it's also about aunts and uncles and small pets and government work especially. Any kind of service-oriented work, even charitable causes. You know, because it's in Drishti with the 12th house, opposite of the 12th house. So in a lot of ways, you can use your sixth house service to balance out your karma. So you're working on your karma right now. Relationship-wise, things should be good. I mean, Venus and Saturn together, it's like you're either celebrating a long-term relationship or you're in love with someone who's older and makes you feel secure. Beyond that, we have Pluto and Mars and the Moon this Friday, Saturday in your eighth house. So there's a lot of transformation energy, letting go, deep lust, all of that. I mean, I think like Sunday and Monday will be the better days for you because of the Moon in Aquarius. Like if you were taking an extra day for the weekend, Monday off, and just going out Sunday, Monday, those are really good days for you. We also have Neptune in the workplace, so it's really hard to get a clear idea of what's going on, where you stand at work. Your social life is still fun, and you got a lot of creative ideas, a lot of love because of Jupiter transiting the fifth house. All right, well, hello, Cancer, and welcome to your horoscope. So, you know, Cancer does well with Scorpio because it's another water sign, so water on water. So I'm thinking, you know, Wednesday is going to be a great day with the Pisces moon, Sun and Scorpio. All the water signs be very happy. Cancer should be very happy that day. The weekend, it looks romantic in a lot of ways with Moon Friday transiting in the seventh house, along with Mars there and Venus still in the sixth, but getting close to the seventh. Next week you'll have Venus in the seventh, so your love life is going to get a lot better, Cancer. And plus, Sun and Mercury are in the fifth. You're in the mood to have fun, and having fun is part of what makes the love thing work. There's a lot of responsibility in your life, but there's unpredictable things. You know, with Uranus, you might be the person that's bringing in all new computers and copiers and all kinds of technology to your workplace, solar energy system, whatever. Or you could be the person who's new at all of this and all of it breaks down and goes into crazy confusion. I'm not really sure. It could go either way. But on the nice side of things, you know, Neptune, you know, your faith in your spiritual life is bringing you good favor. And I think a lot of times, you know, I forget this, but I sometimes remember when I just like stop and just slow everything down and, you know, just have a time of meditating where I can receive clear thoughts, things that are good. Then things go a lot better. So it's a good time to meditate. Well, hello, Leo. And welcome to your horoscope. So, you know, like, I've had this friend, he was saying that during Leo time, we all shine as Leos. But when it comes to Scorpio time, we're like, whoa, let's get back. And one of my Leo friends says, well, you know, Scorpio scares me because it's like the one sign that can put out my fire. It's a water sign and it's also Mars ruled. So there's a force, you know. And I mean, we usually use water to put out our fires. And, you know, the effects of fire are superficial compared to the long-term effects of water. Now, on our bodies, I think fire's a lot worse in a lot of ways. Because you get burns, those will be permanent scars. You know, if you survive a drowning, I mean, you know, you're probably going to be okay after. You know, we got to take a bath sometimes, all of us, right? So, I mean, Scorpio time affects your home life. It affects your family. It affects your foundation. Mercury's there. So maybe you're getting some more information about the history of your family and why things have come on the way they've come on. Why you've had to see things the way you've seen them. Yeah. Because it's not always easy to understand that. But when we get to the roots of our stuff, our foundation of life, this happened to you when you were a little kid. This is what happened to your mom and dad when they were little. Those things are important. It's good to know those stories. Well, the whole Capricorn thing, you know, this weekend with Moon and Mars and, you know, Venus almost there, but Pluto, Mars, and Moon, is that we've got this whole thing where you got to pay attention to health issues. Make yourself better. I mean, it's really easy to get sick in the fall because you're getting colder now, weather's changing, and, you know, you just need to check with yourself, check yourself before you wreck yourself. I think Neptune also, you know, transiting the eighth house, you know, there's just this more morbid view of life, or, you know, maybe spiritual sexuality, really getting into the occult and into magic and, you know, positive thinking. Doesn't hurt. You know, you can change things by changing the way you think. Uranus in the ninth house. Sometimes we have to go to other faiths, other institutions than what we're normally comfortable with in order to get a breath of fresh air, something that inspires us. We have to increase our spiritual education in order to get that inspiration. And I mean, you got good friends around you. You know, you got good family, you got good people. Some of them want to take shortcuts. That's not good. And hold on there, you know. Just a cotton picking minute. Yes, healthy boundaries are good. Well, hello, Virgo. Welcome to your horoscope. So, your deal is analysis. Your key phrase is I analyze. But you have other gifts. It's like you're like the sign of the wilderness. You're the sign of natural systems. And wanting to get to nature, be one with nature. Scorpio time. Symbolic of your third house. That's the environment. So, I mean, Virgo's about environmentalism. So this is a time where you really discover what that means. Your relationship with your neighbors, your relationship with your siblings, your relationship to your handwork. What kind of things do you like to do? Do you do pottery? Do you play guitar? Do you type? How do you communicate? How do you work with your hands? Those are key third word things. And what's your relationship with your siblings and people you grew up with? People that you knew in high school and college even. So that's all those issues are, you know, big for Virgo right now. Communication's good. Mercury changing the third house. I mean, you know stuff. You're understanding things. Your understanding is deep. Your understanding is rich. The weekend looks like fun. I would highly recommend travel. I'd highly recommend doing something fun this weekend. Venus is going to move into the fifth house, but we got Pluto, Moon, Mars there. It's time to celebrate matters of the heart, adventure, open up, get ready to do things good. Well, hello, Libra, and welcome to your horoscope. So, I mean, here's a cool thing. Yeah, I know, set it up right. You got Jupiter in the first house. So whenever Jupiter is doing a transit in your sign, I mean, it's kind of like your lucky year. Because there are really no bad Jupiters. I mean, Jupiter does good things. There's some Jupiters that may not be as good as others, but generally speaking, they're all good. They all have some spiritual wisdom. They all have some material wealth to offer. And they also have relationship wealth, too. It's when you follow your higher principles and you take great risk for what you're passionate about. That's when you reap the rewards. A lot of Libras are passionate about equality, so they're trying to bring that into focus. That is rough. You know what the equality is when you're on that merry-go-round as a kid and you discover if I get to the center of this thing, they can't throw me off. So I think as more of us get to the center, just like this wheel, if it's moving around really fast, every planet on the outside would go first before the one that was in the center. So go into that place of oneness. So Scorpio time is symbolic of material wealth in your life, how your family pushes your buttons too. And so all of that's going to be going off. There are no shortcuts to your karma. There are no shortcuts to making things work out with your mother and what she's agitated about. I have no idea what that is, you know, or your father and what he's upset about. You know, family, older adults, they're kind of a focus. This weekend, you know, by the time we get to Sunday, it's going to be nicer. You'll be feeling a little more creative. Good time to hang out with your kids, play around. Yeah, you got that. Hello, Scorpio. And welcome to your horoscope. So, I mean, here we are. This is going to be like the middle week of Scorpio. So this hits us all of us, whether you're born on the 23rd of October or the early on the 22nd of November. It's, you know, you're all in there this week. You're all feeling something. And when I see Mercury conjoined with the Sun in Scorpio, I think, you know, not so much that Mercury's combust, but I think, what is the combination of intelligence, Mercury, and will in a Scorpio context? Well, Scorpio's thing is to dig deep. Don't just look on the surface. Find out what the root of the situation is in some respect. It's also a place where we're concerned with making love, making money, having an impact in the world. It's sort of like Scorpio is the one sign that's concerned about where their progeny is going. Even if they don't have kids, how their creative works will be treated even after they die. You know, it's fertility to the max. So we're spreading this thing. Now, Capricorn Moon. This weekend's nice for having a neighborhood gathering, being with friends, celebrating creative arts in some way, working on environmental issues. All those things will be really good this weekend. We're in a waxing moon period, rather. So, you know, energy's gaining. So, you know, pay attention to your communiques. And your spiritual life with Jupiter in the 12th is very illuminated right now. You know, God's got an ear for you. If you ever thought you were going to get it, this would be a year where you could get it as far as, like, spiritual enlightenment goes. I mean that. I mean, it's not for everybody. You know, there are philosophies that say it is. I don't think everybody's going to get it. You know, you don't run a society with everybody being a mechanic, everybody being an anything. You know, everybody's not going to be a mechanic because someone's going to have to cook dinner. You know, not everybody can be a shaman because someone is ultimately going to have to grow your food. You know, you can't have everybody doing everything. We can embrace and appreciate what everyone has, but we can't expect everyone to do everything. But you do your shaman thing, Scorpio, will be good. Hello, Sagittarius. Welcome to your horoscope. What a wonderful time indeed. So because of this responsibility And your reliability, you're attracting better friends. You're attracting better people in your life. So I see this whole thing with Venus moving through, you know, your sign with Saturn. Concrete ways of increasing our income and making money. That's what this is all about. And you're going to do it, you know, but you're going to have to take risks. Now, Scorpio times is 12th house transit, so be careful in a 12th house transit because you can be a part of your own undoing, and you don't want to be a part of your own undoing. You know, you want to just be doing, you know, most of us, that's what we want. We want to be doing. We don't want to be having to, you know, make up for the past. But you've got, you know, beauty, you've got reliability. This is a good weekend for making money. A good weekend to have influence in your neighborhood. You might be feeling a little more sensitive as we get towards the middle of the week. You know, your emotional buttons are much more likely to be pushed then. It's just a good heads up. And, you know, otherwise you've got creative inspiration and you know what to do with it. Well, hello, Capricorn. And welcome to your horoscope. We're starting off with Moon in Capricorn today. So wonderful. We had Moon go into Capricorn last night. So, I mean, if you're watching this in the morning, it's in the Mula Nakshatra. So we're in kind of this new lunar cycle this week. And this lunar cycle is about seeking moksha, just letting go of all the BS. And it's like, we're getting into the more magical, mystical, less intense, desire-driven part of Scorpio. We're really enjoying the creative and imaginative process this week. Scorpio rules your social life and fortunate friends. So every Capricorn needs to have a series of Scorpio friends to help them with their trip. That's just part of it. Your Capricorn without Scorpio friends, or Capricorn rising without Scorpio friends, I would say, change that. Find them. They will help you. They will elevate you socially. They'll bring good opportunities for you. And now that Saturn is in your 12th house, along with Venus, you're looking for concrete ways to make your karma good. And, you know, besides just making your karma good right now, getting ready to be a more loving, creative person, because Venus is going to go in your first house next week. And that's going to bring on the love. It's going to bring on the creative relaxness. You're going to like it. You're going to like the way you look with Venus in your first house. I promise you. All right. So, Aquarius, welcome to your horoscope. Big doings. Scorpio rules your 10th house. What's the 10th house all about? 10th house is about career. It's about manifesting in ways that are useful to the public. So this is why you get acknowledged. This is why 10th house is symbolic also where the sun shines. And so there's some sunshine being put on your abilities over the next couple weeks, Aquarius. So I would take advantage of that. And your social house, the 11th house, it's got Saturn and Venus there. You're establishing yourself well that way. Jupiter in the 9th house. This is a good year for travel, a good year to educate yourself. You've also got, you know, some karmatic stuff to deal with on Friday and Saturday with the Moon, Mars, and Pluto all over there. I would just lay low, you know, Friday night, Saturday night, just don't even bother so much. I mean, it'll get better by Saturday night, I should say, but a little bit. But I think, you know, Sunday and Monday, those will be the days where the moon is in Aquarius. You'll be rocking it. All right. Well, greetings, Pisces, as we wind this thing up. So, we've got Neptune right now in your first house, and so you're bringing a spiritual vision for us all to live by. This is Saturn and Venus in the 10th house, so you're able to accept your position of leadership with a lot more grace right now, and who knows, we could all use some grace. We are going to have a moon in Pisces this week, and that's going to happen Tuesday afternoon, and which I will say it is favorable to Hillary Clinton because, you know, she has a moon in Pisces, and I'll just like say, yeah, I mean, come on. It's, you know, they're not fair, okay? Let's all agree, this was not fair, okay? We're just kind of like, swallowing it. So you can stay in the club, you know. Oh, yeah, hi, I know, I did too. I feel a sense of belonging. Yes, I'm one of those fans. Let's all hug each other. No. I get it. No, you know, it's dangerous stuff. But anyhow, that moon in Pisces, you know, it's actually going to be really great on Wednesday. There's going to be this great feeling overall. Not only that, but it's Susan Tedeschi's birthday that day, too. So, you know, and Spiro Agnew. So there you get best of both worlds. You know, and Alice Coachman. But anyhow, that's going to be a great day for you. And it'll continue through Thursday, you know, up until, you know, Thursday night. And, you know, when the moon goes into Aries. And, you know, you've been a great audience. I love doing this with you. Let's do this again. Let's have a great week. Let's discover ourselves on a deeper level. It's Cosmic Kev of the Cosmic Forecast. Enjoy November and Scorpio time.